All right, exciting news. Now listen, over the past couple of days, we've had the privilege of having former Bafana coach Gordon Igesund chatting to us about World Cup fever. But now there's another kind of fever around the Mother City, a very exciting one. The fact that yesterday was a special day in the launch of the Hamilton's Football Academy that Mr. Gordon Igesund himself launched. I think that is, it deserves a round of applause on this Monday morning. Congratulations,
I want you to look at the smile on this man's face now as he starts talking about this. You looked like a young man buzzing around those fields yesterday. I have to thank you for giving us an inside window into what was truly the football played on these pitches, and we're going to have a full breakdown of the tournament later this week. It was superb. The structures that these kids were employing, the innate understanding of the game, and these are young men. Gordon, I would imagine a couple of PSL teams have come knocking on your door ahead of the new season, yet you've chosen to put your knowledge, your football might into these young players. Why? Why?
You know, Graham, it's a long story. I've been involved in football in South Africa now for over 30 years. You know, coaching at the highest level. I've won many championships, as you know, many cup competitions. I've coached Bafana. I won the, played against Spain, the world champions, the European champions, and beat them. You know, we played against Russia, and Russia got a standing ovation off the field. And, you know, you get to a stage where you say to yourself, you know, what can I do now to give back? You know, football's really been good to me over my life, you know, and the biggest problem I had when I was with Bafana was that I found I had to coach players at that level. And I don't think that a national team coach has to coach players at that level. You know, you've got to come up with a game plan, tell the guys, listen, boys, this is how we're going to play today. This is what I want you to do. This is how we're going to do our corners. This is how we're going to do our free kicks. Be aware of this and be aware of that. Manage the players and go out there. And I found that I had to do a lot of coaching. And I thought to myself, you know, why would I have to give a player who's 27 years of age a debut in the national team? He should have been having his debut when he was 20 or 19.
Yeah.
And I think starting now to, with the under-13s, under-11s, under-9s, under-11s, under-12s, under-15s, we can really coach those boys. And our dream, you know, my partner, Bryn Ressel, we share a passion of giving back to the communities. He's a philanthropist, and we want to give back, and we want to create education opportunities for kids. We've done that already. We've got bursaries with one or two of our kids. And we want to really give back and coach the kids. And I think that's what our dream is. And if we can change one life in a year, you know, and we have done that already, that's going to make us happy, and it's all worthwhile. Yeah.
I'm glad that you mentioned education earlier on. We were talking about our Mandela Day quote for today being that education is the most powerful tool that you can use to change the world. So how are you balancing, I guess, the rigorous routine that these kids will have to go through in order to gain those basics of football, but also maintain their education and academic standards so that they're not just dependent on
football? That's a great question, because, you know, what we do at Hamilton's is, obviously with the permission of the parents, we like to get the players' reports. We have tutors who will look after the kids when they're having a tough time in certain subjects, because it's so important. And a kid can go through an academy, become really a good player, and all of a sudden break his ankle or not become the same player. And he needs to have something to fall back on. And we put our kids through these situations. And, you know, if a kid is batting a little bit in Afrikaans or in English or in maths, you know, we'll get a tutor in, sit with him before he trains, and we'll tell him, listen, you can't train until you've done your half an hour with the tutor, whatever the case may be. So we get the balance right, because we really believe that education is, as you said yourself, it's a great tool to have, and we need it, you know. And also the intelligence of the players. I mean, we've got players that are really sharp, and, you know, in South African football, sometimes you often hear now we look behind, you know. So I think the intelligence and having that kind of knowledge and being given the opportunity to have that. I mean, we have kids, we go on a weekly basis into places like Khayelitsha and see kids there, and we see them on a regular basis and we coach them. But not only do we want to coach the players, I also want to try and coach the coaches, because when we leave them, we don't go back. Those coaches will have a little bit more
legacy,
you know, have a little bit more to go and know why they're doing certain things. So, you know, we also there are certain schools who are the beneficiaries of our dream, and we're going into schools now and doing the kids in schools and the teachers. So all we want to do is create players for Bafana. That's what we want to do, really, you know, and give them the opportunity, because, you know, the kids today just want to play football. They love it and they enjoy it, and why not try and empower them and their coaches?
I love that. Cool. And the sweetest thing was watching about 500 kids running around saying, coach, 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 coach. You can see the mentor role that you've stepped into there. But congratulations on a stellar launch. Can't wait to reveal some of the action that went on those fields, too. The goals that I saw being scored yesterday, truly remarkable stuff. So we're going to keep Gordon around to chat a little bit more,
All I want to know is it too late for us, coach?
For me, it is too late.
Is it too late? I mean, I still got some energy in these legs.